Hey, what's that?
This?
Yeah, that. Can I see
it? Let me show you. Hold on.
Can I make one of these?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
So Cynthia, what is this thing and how did it make it all the way to me?
Drew, this is called the hover disc and it made its way to you by hovering. So the fan inside is drawing air into this chamber and it's trapping it. And when the pressure builds up so much, the air releases out of the bottom, creating that lift, which allows it to float along.
And I imagine the type of surface that it was on helped.
Absolutely. Flat surfaces are much, much better for it.
And where did the idea to make a hover disc come from?
I actually made a hoverboard back in high school using like wood, a leaf blower, and plastic bag.
Oh my gosh.
It's a cool physical phenomenon. So we thought, why not make it so that every kid can build it?
What was it like to design this?
Well, it might look simple, but there's actually a delicate balance between power and weight going on here. We want it to float, right? So it needs to be light enough to float, but also powerful enough to glide and move around because that's where the fun is. And to help it float, we use super light materials like this foam, and we started shaving down 1 gram, 2 gram, anywhere we can get some weight off of it.
1 or 2 grams, that doesn't seem like a whole lot. Why is that so significant for this?
1 or 2 grams we found was enough to even disturb the balance of it floating. So taking off 2 grams, it could lift up a little bit higher, and that was enough.
So probably not gonna be a great mechanism for delivering things.
Not in its current form, no.
So I'm about to build one of these things. What advice would you give to me?
The best advice I can give you is to create a good seal up top because okay. We want the air to only come out of the bottom. So just make sure your screws are tightened and all the parts are fully down.
Okay, I'll try my best.
Sounds good.
Let's get to it.
Let's get to it.
First, we're going to grab our battery pack and remove this tab. This tab is in there so that it doesn't drain battery while the crate is on the way to you, and you don't really need it anymore because you want the electricity to start flowing. And now we're going to snap this battery into place. We're going to move one side in and then kind of have the second part snap in like that. And then we're going to take these two wires and feed them through this hole. Next, we're going to take this center ring here, and we're going to make sure that this lip is facing up. Feed these wires through this hole. I'm lining up these three holes and snapping them into place. We're going to flip this over and make sure that this side is flat, and we're now going to connect the motor. Just make sure to line up the semicircle with the opening of the piece right here. Next, we're going to grab this yellow cover and place it over here. Make sure that this wire is out of the way. Make sure all the holes are aligned and the yellow piece is securely connected to the motor. If your yellow cover is a little loose like this, then it's not fully on. You don't want it to be moving like that. You want to click it in and have it not be able to move in that way. Let's do our first stop and check. So make sure that the motor is still flush after you place this cover on. The three legs of the cover should be lined up with these holes on the center ring. Next, let's grab some spacers and bolts and screw them into these holes. We're gonna put this one through until it snaps all the way through. And we're gonna hold it as we tighten this in until it's snug. Now we're going to do this for the other two holes as well. Now it's time to add your fan. Grab it and attach it to the motor like so. You may need to push hard all the way down until it snaps into place.
Did you know that this fan is the heart of your hover disc?
Oh.
When it spins, it'll push air down to lift the disc off the ground. Not a lot, but just enough to let it glide without friction to slow it down.
Awesome, that's really neat. Now connect the wires together, take one from the battery, one from the motor, and connect them here outside of the green spacers. Here's a tip for handling your wires. It's safest to hold them by the connectors. Otherwise, it's possible to tug too hard and the wires will break. Grab your foam shell and drop in your fan. Make sure you're using the side with the deep grooves, not the side with shallow grooves, or else it won't fit. We're gonna flip this over, and we're going to have one hand press from the top and one hand press from the bottom. I'm gonna have to push all the way down and stretch from the inside to make this fit. Now we're going to flip it over once more. Take this wire and connect the lights. Like so. We're going to take this light and make note of where your notches are. There should be three notches, one on each side of this. And line them up with these green spacers. Let's cover up the top of the lights with this wooden piece here. Make sure that the blank side is up, not the side that has the text on it. Blank side up, and we're going to match it up with these holes. Grab your cover and peel both sides first. And line up the holes and rest this on top of the foam. You can adjust that later. We're gonna grab a few more bolts and grab the orange ring here, and we're going to line up the holes from this ring with the holes below. Then we're going to press these through and twist the bolts into place. You don't have to twist too tight here, just make sure that they're in there. Okay, there's another stop and check here. Just turn on the battery pack. The fan will spin and the lights will glow. It's okay if it doesn't quite hover yet.
Make sure the battery is off.
Let's tuck the foam into the skirt here. You may need to stretch out the foam from the inside, and it should look like this when you're done. To get your disc working at its best, make sure that no air can escape from the top edges. If air is escaping, it's gonna be harder for your disc to move. So for this step, you're going to be using the wooden multi-tool to screw the ring really tight. Before moving forward, look at the disc from its side. It should be really flat. You may need to take turns pressing down on the ring and the cover to check that air isn't escaping from anywhere, and then tighten if needed. Once you've made sure that no air is escaping at all, you can turn on the battery pack. And if you really want to test whether your hover disc is working or not, then use a smooth surface to set it down on, like a hard floor or a table. Remember, your crate comes with wiggly eyes, so you can customize our little friend here and give it life. Cynthia, I just finished this part of the build. How's this looking?
It looks great. Mind if I share some troubleshooting tips?
I'd love to hear.
You're gonna make sure the foam skirt fully surrounds the edge of the cover. If not, you can return to part B, steps 7 to 8 for more details. If the fan rubs against the clear cover or makes a noisy sound, so like when you turn it on, it's going da-da-da-da-da-da-da, you're gonna check part A, steps 4 to 6. One way that I can do it from here is you can actually just reach your hands in there and kind of push down the motor a little bit and see if that helps. Make sure the battery is off. If the fan or lights don't turn on, make sure the tab is pulled out of the battery pack, right there. Then check that all the wires are fully connected. If that doesn't work, ask your grown-up assistant to check that the batteries are still in place inside. And finally, make sure the foam skirt isn't squished out of shape. Pinch the bottom edge and reshape it away from the center ring so it's even all the way around. So like you're playing and suddenly you like dent an area, it hits something and your foam is a little messed up, you can just, whoop, bring it back up to shape.
Thanks for all of the tips, Cynthia. Time to start on part 3, arena!
All right.
First, let's fit our post buttons into the base. And there's a little notch here that you want to make sure is perfectly aligned, or else it won't quite fit. With the piece resting against the table like this, you'll want to take a spring and place it inside. Add a stopper to the button. The notch fits this part. You may need to press a little hard to get it all the way down. And flip it back over. Try pressing down on the button. It should pop right up. Place the rubber feet over the button. You can match up the tab and the notch. Then place the rubber into the groove here. This is the way that the rubber feet should be facing. We're going to make three more posts and just repeat the steps from 1 to 5. Grab your elastic cord, place it into one of the posts, then push down on the posts and have the elastic fit all the way back. Repeat the same thing, but now on the other side. If you need to adjust the position, push down and slide the elastic. Grab some heavy stuff from home. It could be a soup can or a stack of books. Place the heavy object on this end of the rubber feet. The weight should be close to the post and centered on the foot like this. If you're finding that the foot moves around when you stretch that elastic, add some more weight, then stretch it. To make sure the elastic cord doesn't snap, hold the post and the elastic securely each time you remove a weight or make any other sort of adjustments. Before finishing up, let's stop and check. Make sure that the elastic doesn't droop anywhere and pull the rubber feet further apart or adjust the elastic until it's taut. Now it's time to grab your disc and get ready to play. I did it. I made the hover disc.
Yay!
How'd I do?
You did great.
Thank you.
Before we get to playing, You remember these little posts that you made?
Yes, vividly.
If you find that it's not working correctly, like you're pushing down and it's not coming back up, you can take a paperclip. You're gonna push the paperclip in to wiggle the stopper loose a little bit, push down on the button, and then everything should fall out. And that way we can then see what's going on. If everything's okay, I'm just gonna pop it back in and push it back in together, and you're ready to go.
Cynthia, I am so excited. What should I know before I start?
First you need a smooth surface.
Okay.
You also need some weights. Books are great. And you also need to make sure your elastics are taut. As you begin to start playing, I suggest you start off with a closed loop just to see how it works.
Okay.
You can put the ends of the elastic into the same post to create this shape.
Okay, let's enter the triangle of fun.
And give it a little push.
So it just kind of bounces around, does its thing,
Finds
its way in the world.
And you can extend this. Instead of making a triangle, you can make a square.
Mm-hmm.
You can use other things in your house, like chairs or tables, to make various shapes as well.
I'm sure the different shapes causes it to bounce and rebound in different ways.
Yes. Bowling is also really fun. You can set up two separate elastics to create a bowling alley. Another classic is the shuffleboard. You can use tape to mark a start line and target zones, and you can assign a point system.
And what if I was feeling maybe a little bit competitive?
You can grab a friend to play some hockey.
Hockey, love it. Thank you so much for building along with us. And if you want to see more fun videos, subscribe below.
Similar to how like ice skaters float on like a layer of water, we have the hover disc kind of floating.
They do?
They do.
Actually, I have no idea.
Okay, yeah.
Whee! What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
Strawberry.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's unique.